I'd like to call to order the 21st regular meeting of the 2020-21 Common Council. Would the clerk please read the quote for the day?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Our lives are defined by opportunities, even the ones we miss.
Thank you very much. Would the clerk then please call the roll?
Alderperson Bourne?
Here.
Alderperson Donahue?
Here.
Alderperson Feldy?
Here.
Alderperson Ackley?
Here.
Alderperson Phillips?
Here.
Alderperson Decker?
Here.
Alderperson Sorensen?
Here.
Alderperson Savaglio?
Present.
Alderperson Filicki-Pineski?
Here.
Alderperson Mitchell?
Here.
There are 10 present.
Thank you very much. Next is the Pledge of Allegiance. Those in the council chambers, please stand and join me.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Then we'll go on to approval of the minutes from our 20th council meeting held on January 18th. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to approve the minutes from our previous meeting.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on those minutes? Seeing none, all those in favor of the minutes as printed, please signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Then we'll move on to item 4.1, confirmation of mayoral appointments. I'll turn it over to City Attorney Charles Adams.
So the appointment is submitted by the mayor for your consideration, and it is William Bolson to be considered for appointment to the library board to fill a vacancy with the term expiring on April 19, 2021.
Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to approve the appointment.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Would the clerk please call the roll for confirmation?
Ten ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.1 is a resignation. All City Attorney Adams.
Thank you. One resignation to submit from the mayor as well, and that is Martha Lepinen, who is resigning from the Senior Activity Center Commission effective immediately.
Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to accept the resignation.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. All those in favor of accepting the resignation, please signify by saying aye.
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 Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion passes. Is there anyone for public forum this evening?
There's no one this evening.
Okay, then we'll go on to mayor's announcements. Our annual survey for the city is out. Please help shape Sheboygan by taking the city's annual community survey. This survey provides feedback to city staff and officials that is utilized to improve the quality of life and services that we provide in our community. The online survey takes less than 10 minutes to complete, and participants will be entered in a drawing to win $100 in chamber cash. We value the input received from our community as we strive to make Sheboygan someplace better. Please go to the website banner ad, click it to take the survey, and this will be available through February 22nd. The city continues to accept applications for Small Business Emergency Assistance Program to help our local businesses stay in business. The new federal guidelines have been provided to allow these CARES Act funds to be used even if you've used other CARE Act funds from like the Paycheck Protection Program. To date, this program has helped about 20 small businesses and provided about $200,000 in support. There's about $200,000 left to assist. Applications are being accepted on a first-come, first-served basis. And for more information, you can contact Chad Pelichek, the Director of Planning and Development, at 459-3383 or visit the city's website. The Spirit of Sheboygan County Awards nomination deadline is coming up on February 9th. Consider helping the United Way to recognize some of the countless people who have been a bright light during these trying times in this last year. There are new award categories beyond volunteerism this year that mirror the efforts that have been made in our community. The nomination portal is open through February 9th on the United Way website. Spring primary election will be held on February 16th. The ballot for the spring election will include voting for State Superintendent of Public Instruction, Sheboygan Mayor, and Sheboygan Area School District Board members. In-person absentee voting begins tomorrow at the City Clerk's office on weekdays from February 2nd through February 12th. Voting hours are from 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., with extended hours on February 12th being open from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. I want to recognize our streets department for all the work that they did plowing the streets during two snowstorms that we experienced last week. Thanks for a great job of moving the snow to keep our streets as passable as soon as possible. Next, we'd like to update the COVID-19 situation. First of all, let's review the numbers for Monday, February 1st. We have a total of 12,463 positive cases. That's up only 115 from last week's numbers. We now have 457 active cases in the county, and that's down 139 cases from last week. We have 11,892 that have recovered. That's up 252 from last week. And there are 5 people that are hospitalized with COVID. That's down 3 from last week. Death total went up by 2 during the last week, from 112 to 114. And the total negative tests are up 491 to 43,239. The Sheboygan County COVID activity level is currently very high, but we've had a 42% decrease in our trajectory in the last month. The current burden rate is at 364 per 100,000 persons. If this trajectory continues and our burden rate goes under 350 per 1,000 persons, the Sheboygan County activity level will improve from very high to high. Currently, there are 12 registered vaccinators in the Sheboygan County area. Of those, 5 have received vaccine and all are able to assist with phase 1A vaccinations. The Pharmacy Partnership Program has launched and there are 9 skilled nursing homes in Sheboygan County that have started their second round of vaccinations this week. There's a limited supply from the state and is currently preventing all vaccinating sites from operating at full capacity. Aurora has moved their vaccination clinic to the Southside Aurora Clinic and they'll be open 6 hours a day. St. Nicholas Hospital has a little over 3,000 people that have been vaccinated, and that clinic is going to be moving to the UWGB Sheboygan campus. They will have a soft opening on February 3rd and will be open starting February 4th. You can schedule appointments through myprevea.com. And Lakeshore would have the capacity to do 300 people on a Saturday clinic if the vaccine is available. The Wisconsin National Guard is still testing people for COVID. Last week, 76 people were tested. They're only operating one day a week now. And if you're referring someone to the site, please pre-register at register.covidconnect.wi.gov. And testing is only available on Wednesdays from 9 to 5, and that'll currently scheduled through March 10th. Thank you. We'll continue with our agenda. We'll be going on to the consent agenda. That'll include items 2.3 through 2.11. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to receive and file all ROs, receive all RCs, and adopt all resolutions and ordinances.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on any of those items in the consent agenda?
I have, Mr. Mayor.
Please go ahead, Roberta.
I was very impressed with the fire report and the police report, and I'm understanding it was 210 and 211. I'm understanding that that comes out quarterly. My question is this: do those departments publish an annual report similar to the DPW report that we see?
Yes, they do. Those are going to be all due soon, and they'll be published in our newsletter as well as posted on our website.
Perfect. Thank you.
Any other discussion? Seeing none, I'll ask the clerk to call the roll for passage.
Ten ayes.
Motion passes. Under reports of officers, item 3.1 through 3.5 will be referred to various committees. Moving on to resolutions, items 4.1 through 4.9 will again be referred to various committees. Under reports of committees, item 5.1 is RC number 240 of 2021 by the Finance and Personnel Committee, to whom is referred direct referral resolution number 151 of 2021 by Alderpersons Donahue and Bourne, authorizing the appropriate city officials to execute an amendment to offer to purchase with Martin's Trilling True Value, extending the closing date to July 30th of 2021 due to continued environmental testing. Alderperson Donahue.
Thank you. I move to adopt the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on that motion? Seeing none, will the clerk call the roll?
Ten ayes.
Motion passes. Item 5.2 is RC number 241 of 2020 by the Public Works Committee, to whom was referred direct referral resolution number 152 of 2021 by Alderpersons Decker and Sorensen, authorizing the appropriate city officials to enter into a contract with Foth Infrastructure and Environment LLC for design services related to the Southside Interceptor System rehab access road shoreline protection program. Alderperson Decker.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to adopt the resolution.
Second.
Thank you for that motion and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none, will the clerk please call the roll for passage?
Ayes.
Motion passes. Under other matters authorized by law, I'll turn it over to City Attorney Charles Adams.
7.1 is a resolution by Alderpersons Decker and Sorensen, authorizing the appropriate city officials to enter into an agreement with Sheboygan Athletic Club, Inc. regarding the operation and management of Wildwood Baseball Park.
That'll be referred to the Public Works Committee.
7.2 is an RO by the city clerk submitting various license applications for the period ending December 31, 2021 and June 30, 2022.
And that will be referred to the Licensing Hearings and Public Safety Committee. Next is adjournment. Alderperson Sorensen.
Thank you, Mayor. I move to adjourn.
Second.
All those in favor of adjournment, please signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed? We stand adjourned. Thank you for your time tonight.